Hello dear students, here we are back again with our mathematics of class 8. In the previous class, we have studied exercise 3.1 of chapter number 3, that is understanding correlators, and in that we have done question number 7. So in question number 7, after completing question number 7, I told you that the sum of the exterior angle of triangle and the sum of the exterior angle of polygon is 360. And in the next video, I will give you the proof. So here I am to prove that the sum of the measure of the exterior angle of any polygon is 360. See how. So I have drawn one quadrilateral, as you all can see, that is made up, a pentagon, that is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. With 5 figures, with 5 line segments, I have drawn one polygon that is known as pentagon. And with this, along with the lines mentioned, that is A, B, B, C, C, D, D, E and A, E, these are all extended. When I draw any of the polygon, triangle, quadrilateral, when I extend any of the line, then between two adjacent lines, they form an exterior angle. So angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4 and angle 5 are exterior angles. Okay, these all are the exterior angles, and we need to find the sum of the measurement of all these exterior angles. That means when we add all these 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, do we get 360 or not? Let's see. So in question number 7 of exercise 2.1, we have done that sum of the measurement of the exterior angle of the triangle and sum of the measurement of exterior angle of quadrilateral is 360. So this is the pentagon. Let's see what we get in this. So look at me, I am standing at A and I want to move to AB. I am moving to AB, but from B I want to move to C. So I will take turn like this. I have taken turn and make angle 1 exterior angle towards C. Now on reaching C point, I want to move to D. I will move to D and making an angle 2. After reaching to D point, I want to move to this E point. Because I don't want to go up, I want to go to that side. So now after D, I am not going to that, I have to reach into D, I am going to E point. I have reached to E. Now I said, I am very tired. Now I don't want to move to E, I want to come back to my original position. So after E, I will again come to point A and make an angle 4. On reaching angle 4, I have started from A, making angle 5 towards B. Now again I am here. So you have seen, I have taken this turn, this complete turn, and that means this full turn means from point A to B to C to D to E to again E. I have taken full turn, and full turn means you have studied in previous classes. When I make complete angle, full turn, that is the angle of 360 degree. Okay, so I have taken full turn, that means I have moved to 360 degree angle. That means the sum of the measurement of all these angles is 360 degree. So we have proved. You can take the example of triangle, quadrilateral. I have taken the example of pentagon. You can take the example of hexagon and septagon, heptagon, octagon, nonagon, decagon. You will get the same result because you will take the full turn to reach from original position to come back to the original position after reaching to all the points. So we will say that the measurement of the sum of the angle of the exterior angle of any polygon is 360 degree. Clear? Very easy it was. In this way we will say, how will you write and prove that we have walked along AB, move to C, from B move to C, making an exterior angle of 1, angle 1. On moving towards C to D, make an angle of exterior angle 2. Similarly, form exterior angle 3, 4 and 5 on moving towards D to E to A and then again to B. For that, we have taken complete turn like this. And for that, therefore, the measurement of angle 1 plus angle 2 plus angle 3 plus angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 360 degree. This is true for all the number of sides. When you take this any number of sides, any number of polygon, you will form 3 sides, 4 sides, 5 sides. sum of the measure of the exterior angle of the polygon. Exterior I am saying, not interior. For interior the formula is different. For all the sum of the measure of the exterior angle of any polygon will be 360 degree, because when you move from one side to another side and then again to back to the original position with by taking full turn, you take the and make the angle of 360 degree, and then that is why the sum of the measure of all the exterior angle is 360 degree. And for the sum of the measure of interior angle is something different formula. The general formula is n minus 2 into 180, where n is the number of sides. If three sides are there, so 180 into 180, that means 180. If four sides are there, 4 minus 2 into 180, that is 2 into 180 is 360. If five sides are there, 5 minus 2 into 180, that is 3 into 180 is 540. Similarly, for 6 sides, 7 sides, 8 sides, the interior, to find the measure of the interior angle is different, but for exterior angle it is 360 degree. So according to this proof, we will do all the questions given in exercise 3.2. So let's start with 3.2.